What's your name, soldier?
Marius. But my name is of no import. My story, however, is...
You must save Rome. Save it from there.
And of those who venture there, few return.
I can hardly let you have all the glory now, can I?
Your empire needs you. Rise.
Fight for your father. Fight for your legion. Fight for Rome.
Roman literature is also known as Latin literature. This type of literature had produced various literary works that focuses in poetry, comedy, tragedy, satire, history, and rhetoric. Most of its literary pieces deals on real-life situations encountered every day by the people. Although Roman literature had struggled in the past centuries of its existence because of various wars, still, lots of its literary works became famous and popular. One of its popular literary pieces is the story of Aeneid, written by Virgil, which retold the history of the ancient Rome. Through this story, students of the modern era will be informed on how the Roman Empire fought against their enemies during the late centuries. Aside from this story, there are still a lot of literary pieces that can be discovered from this literature. In fact, nowadays, courses that deal with literature had used most of these literary pieces in their analysis and dealings.
Hello, good day everyone. I know many of us have been wishing to go and travel around the ancient Rome. A continent that is consist of beautiful places and heart-melting sceneries. However, before traveling to that place, one must know the history of its places. That is why I, together with my partners, are here to introduce to you one of its beautiful places. Rome. We're going to trace back this place using the art of literature. So guys, brace yourself because we're here traveling back to the ancient Rome.
Well, now that you have already pricked up those lazy bones and widened those big eyes, I believe that you are now ready. So why don't we travel? Join me. Let's travel to one of the birthplaces of Western civilization.
Go!
literature dates back in the conquest of the Greek cities in southern Italy before the Punic War. It began with dramatic exhibitions of pantomimic scenes of the flute without songs or dialogue from the Etruria in BC 363. It later developed its regular plot in BC 240. Roman literature had its highest excellence under the reign of Augustus, or Emperor Octavian, and declined under his successors. Roman literature has finally lost with the fall of the Western Empire. Rome got its name from Roman, or Roman, the archaic name of the Tiber River, which in turn has the same root as the Greek verb ru and the Latin verb ro, which both mean flow. In Roman beliefs, Rome came from the name of their founder Romulus. He's one of the twins, Remus and Romulus, who first built their city in 753 BC. Rome is the capital of Italy and also of the province of Rome and the region of Latium, later Latium. It is one of the oldest continuously occupied cities in Europe and is referred to as the Eternal City. It's also regarded as one of the birthplace of Western civilization, as it was the capital city of the Roman Kingdom, the Roman Republic, and the Roman Empire in the ancient world. Rome has been considered as the seat of the papacy since the 1st century AD and the capital of the papal states in 8th century until 1870. In 1871, Rome became the capital of the Kingdom of Italy, and in 1946, that of the Italian Republic. Publius Virgilius Maro, or Virgil, was born on October 15, 70 BC, near Mantua, northern Italy. He was a prominent poet of the Roman Empire, whose writings gained him the recognition of the public, wealth from patrons, and the favor of the emperor. He was a meticulous writer and was considered as the greatest poet in the Latin language and a significant writer of antiquity in the Middle Ages and into the Renaissance. He inspired poets across languages, the likes of Dante in Italian, Milton in English, and many more. He is also viewed as a pagan prophet because several lines in his works were interpreted as predictions of the coming of Christ. His works were appreciated for their fluidity in his poetry and his vivid portrays of human emotion among the Renaissance writers. He lived during the first age of the Roman Empire, under the reign of the Emperor Octavian, later known as Augustus. In his youth, Virgil witnessed the following turmoils of his country. First, is the first triumvirate, Julius Caesar, Pompey, and Crassus, who governed the Roman Republic. Second was the death of Croesus and civil war between Caesar and Pompey around 53 BC. Next was the reign and assassination of Caesar in the Ides of March in 44 BC by Brutus and Cassius, or two senators. Octavian's assumption of power and later the title Augustus after defeating Antony and his ally Cleopatra of Egypt at the Battle of Actium in 31 BC. Virgil later died of a fever on September 21, 19 BC. Virgil has three famous works. First was the Eclogues, which was published in the mid-30s BC. It was about a pastoral poem of a world of singing shepherds, which was also filled with references to the contemporary political figures. It is influenced by his rural upbringing. Next was the Georgics, published in 29 BC. It was a poem about a farming, which was dedicated to Virgil's patron, the Roman statesman Gaius Maecenas, who has supported him in his study and writing. It shows his hatred for instability, where farmers were forced to fight thereby, leaving their farms neglected. And lastly, the Aeneid, published in the 19 BC, same year of his death. An epic poem in 12 books, which was based on Homer's two epic poems, the Odyssey and the Iliad. This epic is about the early origin of Rome, as it describes the journey of the Trojan hero Aeneas to Italy and the wars he undertook as he arrived there and built his dynasty. The epic Aeneid, Virgil foreshadows the coming of Augustus, perhaps to silence critics who acclaim that he achieved power through violence and treachery. When Rome was at its height, the easiest way to justify the recent brutal events was to claim that the civil wars and the changes in leadership had been decreed by fate to usher in the reign of the great Augustus.
Virgil crafted the events narrated in the Aeneid from the existing works of the Greek poet Homer. He did not invent the story that Rome descended from Troy. He crafted the events narrated in the Aeneid from an existing tradition surrounding Aeneas that extended from the ancient Greek poet Homer to the contemporary Roman historian Livy. After 11 years of composition, the meticulous Virgil did not consider the Aeneid fit for publication. He planned to spend 3 years editing it, but fell ill, returning from a trip to Greece. Just before his death, he ordered the manuscript of the Aeneid to be burned, because he still considered it unfinished. Augustus intervened, however, arranging for the poem to be published against Virgil's wishes.
So, I'll be the one to give you an activity 3 which regards with our topic Aeneid. So, here comes the instruction. You get a piece of paper, 1/2 crosswise, and you answer the following questions, which are posted below. But after you answer the following questions, you have to make your own concept map, which is a unique concept map. So, see you. Thank you.
Okay, so since we're gonna be discussing about the Roman literature, the story Aeneid, and the life of the author Virgil, we're going to give you a task now, which is what we call literary analysis. Literary analysis, which means you're going to analyze the story Aeneid based on your own approach, okay? So, the instruction will be like this. You're going to encode your answers in a short one paper with a font size of 12, and you're going to submit it to us this night. Okay? So, guys, until 5 p.m. only, see your analysis. Bye-bye.
You're never going out of style. Ooh, pretty baby, this world might have gone crazy. The way you save me, who could blame me when I just wanna make you smile? I wanna do you like Michael. I wanna kiss you like Prince. Let's get it on like Marvin, yeah, like Hathaway. Write a song for you like this. You're over my head. I'm out of